Hi there. Welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie, and it's great to have you here. Today, I want to talk about absolute cell referencing in Microsoft Excel. I actually want to talk about not using cell referencing in Microsoft Excel. Now, don't get me wrong. It's extremely important to know and understand what this means, but I want to show you a different way that you can use naming of a cell to get very similar results. And actually, I find it a little bit more efficient. That's what I want to cover today on Teachers Tech. If you're unfamiliar with absolute cell referencing, here is a lesson. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to do a little multiplication here. This is our sales total. I want it to multiply by this 12%. Okay, so I'm going to start with this and I'm just going to go multiply by this amount and I get 120,000. That's correct. Now the problem is going to happen with this. I don't have any absolute cell referencing on. If I copy this down, these numbers below are incorrect because as it went down to do the formula, notice on the next one, it's D3 times D8. It took the 20,000 and times it by the 800,000 to get this result. I wanted it to make sure it stayed at the 12%. So if I go ahead and delete these here, I can make a little correction making with an absolute cell reference right here. If I go and just add the dollar signs, I'm going to do this by function F4. So the dollar signs in front of the D, in front of the 2, we get this. It doesn't look any different, but now if I copy this down, this is all correct. It always stays at D2. So if no matter which one I click on, it always will stay. That makes it absolute. Now, a different way, and the way I like to do this, is I'm just going to go ahead and delete this. We can actually name a cell. So to do this, now this 12%, I want to call this performance bonus. So I'm going to go up to the name box up here, and I'm just going to type the name of here. So I'm just going to call this performance bonus, just like this, and hit enter. And now what I can do, if I go down here and try the same formula, and this one, multiply D7, multiply performance bonus, all I have to do is start typing it here. So it makes it a little easy to remember, and I can copy this down easily. Now, what I really like about this, I'm going to go to another sheet here where it says sales bonus. Let me give you a couple of different examples. So with the sales bonus, I'm going to go back to this here, and I'm going to name this cell. So rather than it just being D3, I'm just going to type in sales bonus, just like that. And now I'm going to go back to the sales bonus page. So I'm going to do a formula here with an if function. So I'll just start it here. Here is it right here. So it's going to be if sales here is going to be greater than 500,000, what do I want to have happen? Well, it's going to give it the sales. So all I have to do is type it in, sales bonus. Other than that, it's going to be zero. So I'm just going to go ahead and end it. And there it is. I can go ahead and add the dollar sign. I can copy this down. So you notice that it only went to the ones that had above 500,000 on the list. Another one, so let's do this one more time. So this one is the family bonus. If they're family members, they're going to get the $1 billion bonus. So we're just going to go and rename this here. So I'll call this family bonus. And now we'll go to the last sheet here. So again, we'll just do another one. So do the other if. And what's our if this time? So it's going to be if this right here equals ROI. Okay, that's our logical test. Then they're going to get the family bonus. So we're going to get the family bonus. Other than that, they get zero. So let's see. He got the $1 billion. I'll give it some formatting and copy it down. And you can see all the people that are part of the Roy family got the $1 billion bonus. So rather than using absolute cell referencing the next time, try naming the cell and seeing how this works for you. I really like this approach, and I really like it when I'm using different sheets. It makes it just easy to remember once you have it named. Let me know if you like this tip or not. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.